Hi guys, what's up? It's Lindsay and welcome back to my channel. Today I have for you a bag collection of all of the purses and bags that I have thrifted and purchased over the years. And I have been wanting to make a video like this forever because I love watching these videos, especially luxury bag collections. They're just really enjoyable to watch for some reason. I only have two designer bags in this. The rest are mid-tier and like thrifted and different things like that. So I think there's a good mix of everything and hopefully you enjoy it. Maybe you can get some tips on a bag to buy or tips on where to consign bags and things like that. You'll definitely see a theme throughout this that I really enjoy black and gold and neutral bags. That's pretty much all I own is black bags. I might as well just have titled this my black bag collection because I don't really buy colorful bags because they're not practical. Like, these are all very practical bags that I've gotten a ton of wear out of because that's just kind of my personality. I'm a very quality over quantity person, so I'd rather have like 5 really killer nice bags that I can wear all the time than like a ton of really cheap ones. So I also wanted to give a quick thank you to the sponsor of this video, which is Squarespace. Squarespace is an all-in-one platform for creating and hosting beautiful websites, anything from portfolios to online shops, blogs, you name it, you can really make it on Squarespace. I personally use Squarespace for my graphic design portfolio website, and I totally recommend it to other creatives that want to show off their work. It's super easy to use. There are thousands of templates, super fast customer service, extremely customizable so you can still keep your personal style while showcasing your work, and just overall makes the website process a whole lot easier. If you're interested, be sure to go to squarespace.com/LindsayRem or just type in Lindsay Rem at checkout for 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. And now what you've all been waiting for, moving on to the bags. And we are starting off with the cheapest one. This one was $9. I picked it up at a Goodwill and it is from Nine West. It is really the perfect 90s black shoulder bag. It's very minimal, it goes with everything. It has a tiny little zippered pouch on the inside, so it actually does have a decent amount of storage. I really got this to start off kind of like a trial period of liking shoulder bags because they were starting to become trendy, but I didn't want to splurge on one. So I got this little guy and I still love it. And I've had it for at least a year, maybe 2 years. And it's still cute in my personal opinion. So if you are on Depop, check out Nine West. Just type in Nine West and I'm sure you can find a ton of ones like this. But now that they're in style, I don't know if you could find it for $9, but maybe you can. Amazing, that's number one. On to number two, this one is a backpack, but I do still consider it a bag. So this is my Dickies backpack. It has lots of pins on it that I've changed many times. I really went through a backpack phase and I do still love a good small backpack, like if I'm going to the beach or going to a festival. It's pretty like waterproof, water resistant, you can take it anywhere. I also had a red Brandy Melville backpack that I wore all the time, but my sister actually snagged it and has been wearing it, so she has that one. But in general, I do really like a good small backpack when the occasion is right, because I do think that they are kind of a bit of a younger style, like wearing a tiny backpack. In college, this was my go-to everywhere bag. Like if I wasn't going to class with my like actual school backpack, I would be wearing this on the weekends. And it's also $15 or $20, I believe. So I will link it below. You can buy them on Amazon. My mom has one. This next bag is the only one that isn't completely black, and it is this Kate Spade shoulder bag that is brown zebra, and I actually got it on the RealReal for a great price. I think I got it for like, I think $75, but my actual favorite thing about it is that the inside is pink, which is just like a really fun detail when you're going to like open your bag. I currently have a Glossier lipstick in Cake in here, and I have a takeout menu for a really good Italian restaurant. I definitely am more of like a staple bag person, like just having a classic black bag, but it is really fun to have kind of like a statement bag on occasion, and even this isn't very much of a statement. Like, I do find it's still quite neutral, and it also fits deceivingly a lot more than it looks like. And when it arrived, it had a dust bag, it was in a fancy box. I felt very special. And this wasn't even that expensive, because obviously they have a lot of really high-end designer. You can buy like Birkin bags on there, but you can also find things that are pretty affordable. Next up, we have my everyday bag. This is the Rag & Bone Field Messenger bag, and I genuinely wear this every single day to everywhere that I go. I will wear it anywhere from the grocery store, workout classes, to like fancy events, nice dinners, because it is a really nice bag, but it is also not so nice to the point that I'm like afraid to take it places. I love this little front pouch. I put my sunglasses in it whenever I'm going anywhere, and it has a lot of space on the inside. It has two zippers, which I really love. This is not a cheap bag, but this is an investment bag that I have worn every single day since I've owned it. All the hardware is really heavy duty and like industrial. It doesn't look like it's going to break or fade or do anything. If you were looking for just a really high quality everyday bag to wear the living hell out of, I highly recommend this bag because that is why I wanted it. And then while we're at it with everyday items, I figured I would just toss in my wallet since it was in my purse. I got it when I was like 17 or 18, and it is from Marc by Marc Jacobs. I really love it, and it is holding up quite well. It's only very recently started to fray at the seams and kind of like start to detach, which I think I might be able to get repaired before I have to go and buy a new wallet, because I was looking at some like Acne and APC and Margiela wallets, but at the end of the day, this one's working very well, and all I really want is a plain black wallet. But when I do look for a wallet, I love this kind of like square style where you can fit a whole dollar across, but it is still very compact and doesn't take up a lot of space because I have a lot of tiny purses and sometimes I just want to carry my wallet like in my pocket. So this is what my wallet looks like. We have made it to the last two bags in this collection, and these are my two designer bags. So I hold them very near and dear to my heart because I got them during very like sentimental times. And obviously they were quite expensive, so they feel like my children here. This is the first one, and I purchased this when I had finished my second year of college and I hit 300,000 on YouTube. I was feeling really like proud and excited and wanted to do something to commemorate it. So this is the Gucci wallet on a chain. There are about like 100 different sizes and styles of this Marmont style, which really just means like this kind of stitching, and I really liked this size and the fact that it's a wallet because it has kind of like an accordion style inside. There are tons of spots for your cards, and there's a section for coins, and just overall like kind of a lot of space, but it has to be very flat, so it does perfectly fit a phone, and that is kind of about it. A phone and cards and maybe a lip gloss. It also has like a long crossbody strap, but you can twist it around to have a short kind of like shoulder bag style, which I really love doing. I think it just gives it a whole new look, and I do really like this bag. I don't know if it's as my style anymore as it used to be when I first got it, because now I see this kind of symbol everywhere, like on the belts, and I just like, there's some other Gucci styles that I think are more my style and a little less kind of cliche almost, but because of like the emotional attachment to this bag, I think I have to keep it for a little while longer before I sell it. And my mom really loves this bag, so I don't think she would ever let me get rid of it. She would just, you know, take it off my hands. But I do really like it, and if you size up, the back of it will have a heart. I just remember that being like a factor of like, do I want to get a bigger one so that I can have a heart on the back? I didn't do it, but you know, you could do that. And now for the grand finale, I can already feel myself just like smiling very hard. This is my gorgeous vintage Chanel bag that I believe is from the 90s, and I got it on Fashion File, which is another consignment store. It's like The Real Real online. It's great. Love Fashion File. Totally recommend. Had a great experience. I will put all the links to both of those below. Since I was 12 years old and on Polyvore, obsessed with clothing and fashion and celebrities' outfits, I knew that I wanted a Chanel bag, and nothing was gonna stop me from getting it. I knew that when I grew up, I was gonna have a Chanel bag. I also really wanted Louboutins, which now that's totally not my taste, but we can just forget about that. I knew I wanted a Chanel bag and that I was going to get one. So when I was about to graduate college and I discovered that vintage consignment stores exist online, I pretty much fell down a hole of trying to find the perfect vintage flap bag, and I ended up finding this one, and it is unique. It looks different than the regular flap bags. It has a half circle instead of like a straight across line. I just fell in love with it, and I knew I had to get it because it was unique, and I couldn't wait because someone else would buy it. So I pretty much bought it in January when I graduated in May and hid it in my closet for months and pretended that it didn't exist because I didn't want to like get my gift too early, literally from me to me. But I was so excited. On these sites, Chanel bags can range anywhere from like $2,000 to $10,000, just depending on like the quality, the age. If it's brand new, it's obviously going to sell very high because it's brand new. But the vintage ones you can get a pretty good deal on. The reason I got this on such a steal, which I still really can't believe, there is a tear on the inner pocket where the zipper is, and obviously that's something you would never know from looking at it from the outside, but it severely docked the price of it, which I didn't care about. No one knows, and it really doesn't affect the bag at all. I could get it repaired, but I honestly would rather have no one touch it than try to have someone fix it and leave this in someone's hands. It makes me really happy that I not only scored a killer bag, but I also fulfilled my 13-year-old self's dream, and I honestly love this bag. It goes with everything. I don't think I even talked about that. It was mostly just about how I managed to get it. It really was like the first thing that really excited me about fashion when I was younger, so it just makes me really happy. It's such a classic. I don't think it'll ever go out of style, so this will definitely be a family heirloom for the rest of my life, if all goes well. Editing Lindsay here. I actually received a beautiful vintage designer Prada bag from Dreaming of Designer on Instagram literally the week after I filmed this, and I had to include it because it's so cute. So thank you so much for that bag, and how cute is it, guys? I'm obsessed with it. And then I just put an Urban Outfitters wallet chain on it, so that adds the extra chain, and you should totally check out her Instagram. But that is everything for my purse collection. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. I'm sure you only clicked on this if you love bags. Otherwise, this would have been very boring. But thank you so much for watching. Please give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. I'm sure I'll buy more bags in the future. Be sure to tell me what bags you have or if there's anything that's on your mind that you really want to get. And if you're interested in using Squarespace, be sure to check out the first link in the description for 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you all very soon. Bye, guys.